Hello, I'm Stephen Lee, and welcome to Omics Quest. Today's video kicks off Inside Ultima Genomics, a new series where I'll break down the core ideas behind Ultima's technologies. Ultima has been a major innovator in high-throughput sequencing, and I'm excited to dive in. Today, we're exploring their flow-based, mostly natural sequencing by synthesis. Let's break it down. This video assumes a basic understanding of NGS. After library prep, Ultima amplifies DNA on beads using emulsion PCR, similar to Illumina's breach amplification but with key differences. Ultima's amplification happens separately in an external system, while Illumina's occurs directly within the sequencer. After amplification, beads are loaded onto a silicon wafer, which spins to spread reagents and enable efficient optical scanning. Produced using mature semiconductor processes, the wafer is inexpensive to manufacture, helping Ultima reduce sequencing costs to $0.8 per gigabase or $80 per genome by 2025. Founder Gilad Almoji's semiconductor background heavily influences this approach. The UG100 uses flow-based sequencing, similar to the method pioneered by 454 Life Sciences. Nucleotides are added one type at a time, detected by flow signal, and imaged via fluorescent labels without reversible terminators. After imaging, the labels are cleaved and washed away before the next cycle. Thus, Ultima faces a different challenge in sequencing. Illumina must identify which of the four nucleotides was incorporated each cycle, while Ultima must quantify how many nucleotides of a given type were incorporated during each flow. Beyond flow-based chemistry, Ultima also uses a mix of fluorescently labeled and natural nucleotides. This lowers costs and reduces quenching and scarring, common issues in traditional NGS technologies. Let's look at Ultima sequencing in action. This zoomed-in image shows an amplified bead on the wafer. The first two bases are cytosines, with both labeled and natural nucleotides incorporated. Since most nucleotides are natural, some templates may lack labels, but the cluster's collective signal still reflects two cytosines. Note also that base calling is performed by a deep neural network that predicts the most likely homopolymer length. Next, we see the incorporation of one adenine. Finally, we see the incorporation of three thymines, resulting in the sequence CCATTT. A major challenge in flow-based sequencing and all NGS is reduced accuracy in reading homopolymers, though it's more pronounced here. Signal stays proportional to homopolymer length up to a point, then saturates. Ultima is working to improve this, but long homopolymers are rare in the human genome. Another key difference is that Ultima produces variable-length single-end reads, unlike Illumina's fixed-length paired-end reads. For example, instead of paired 150 base pair reads, Ultima generates single 300 base pair reads. Since many tools expect paired-end data, it's common to split these reads to create pseudo-pairs. Nice! Thanks for watching Omics Quest. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel.